everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do a ripped nail look using metallics and a bit of acrylic and a few stars for good measure. Let's get cracking. So I'm going to sculpt this out. We're going to do a stiletto because I am doing it on Abby and she's a goth and oh my God, it needs to be stiletto. It needs to be fierce. So you need to check out my beautiful nightmare. She's a very beautiful nightmare. So check her out on Instagram. She is pretty cool.
I called you a nightmare and everyone thought it was really funny.
I don't find it so funny. Now, if you said a beautiful nightmare, wow. So I'm going to fit this on like I would do for a stiletto. We do have a tutorial that shows you exactly how to fit the form and create a perfect stiletto. You need to check that out. But don't do that now. Keep watching. Check that out after. I've already prepped Abby's nails, so we've removed the surface shine. We've done cuticle work. Now I'm dehydrating with the nail prep dehydrator. And then I'm going to use the Ultra Bond Acid Primer. And you want to let that nail prep dehydrator to completely evaporate and you'll have like a chalky nail. And then you can go in with your primer. I'm going to use medium speed. I do find medium speed with clear sets up a little bit quicker than, say, medium speed with a cover pink colour. I find clear sets up quicker in general. So if you were using high speed, it's going to set up like that, which is great for short nails, great for infills. Also got these beauties. Now, these beauties are from this collection. These little stars are from this collection, which is called... I have no idea. It's some red thing. So you get all these colours in this collection. It will be linked below. All the reds in all the shapes and sizes. But we're going to use these kind of twinkling stars. Not your average star. Only got 4 points. So they're like a little blink. Blink, blink, blink.
Using blinks.
Like it's blinking like. I know what I mean.
I'm glad you do, because I
do. Do you know what I mean?
Like a little twinkle.
Yes.
Not a blinkle.
A blinkle. Oh, it's a little blinkle. So we're going to sculpt it out in clear. First of all, doing a thin layer of clear. So we're going to make contact with the natural nail, tipping the finger down so everything draws down. So it kind of gives you a bit of a head start. And then we can pat and press, pat and press, pat and press, and drag that product down to the length that you want. And then we're going to get some of these stars and place them really randomly. You want to sort of spread them out a little bit. So leave gaps in between, give them a little bit of a press because you want them to really stick. Now you see how that one didn't stick? So we're going to move that and really press that in. Another thin layer of acrylic there because that's where I'm going to put some more stars. And then what we will do is encapsulate with a large bead going low into the powder so I can pick up a really big bead, tipping the finger down again, giving you that head start so it's all falling into place. And then pattern press. I can now lift the finger up because I don't need it to run anywhere. And also it'll stop running as well. Because it's starting to set up. And we're encapsulating those stars inside. Now this nail, just like this, kind of looks really cool. But we're going to make it look even better. I am going to pinch this nail. It's still a little bit too bendy to pinch because I don't want to run the risk of squishing the product up away, and we don't want that. So we're going to leave that pinching tool on there and let it do its thing. Let's take off the foam. Now I'm going to go through my normal filing routine, creating a nice straight side wall. So I'm following the line of the natural side wall. And I'm going to go around the cuticle area. And I'm switching to a soft file. So I've got a 240 grit file to go around that cuticle area, make it really nice and flush. So it looks like it's growing out of the cuticle area. Then I'm going to contour the surface now. So I'm going to buff the nail now, make it nice and smooth.
Smooth.
I'm going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution. And look at that, by magic, they're all done. Ta-da! So, we've got a full set, so what we're going to do, I love this next bit. Very exciting, sorry. We're going to top coat them. So I've seen this kind of look done before, done with chromes. Now I was thinking, oh, a bit of a faff. How can we make this a little bit better and a little bit easier? So I come up with this technique of doing it all with the metallics. You can do it with chrome. I'm just going to show you a totally different way of doing it. Actually, I don't want a top coat. why do I know? I just think because... Right, in a previous video, I used the black metallic straight on the top of the acrylic. And it actually turned out really nice. It was really nice and thin. And for this technique, we can do that. Yeah? Scared?
Why would I be scared?
I'm a little scared. So what we're going to do is paint directly onto the acrylic. Now I don't need to worry about getting super, super close to the cuticle area. And you'll see why after. So we're going to paint them all with the metallic. This is going to look so cool. And I know you're all thinking, what the hell is she doing? She's just covered up all of those gorgeous stones. Not stones, sorry, the stars. Do not worry, my friend. All will be revealed. So because we don't have to get super close to the cuticle, this kind of makes it easier as well. And then we're going to either put that in the lamp to encourage it to dry. It will dry, it will air dry. If it's warm in the room, it will dry. Or you can actually blast it with a hairdryer. Right, so now we're going to top coat.
Why are you going to top coat?
All will be revealed. Right, pop me that into the lamp. And now we're going to use the silver. This one is 45. There's a few different silvers that do have all different kinds of names, but we don't know them at this stage. So we are creating layers. So if you were going to do this in chrome, you'd be chroming now, and then you'd be sealing, and that's what we're going to do. Once this is dry, we're going to cheat and we're going to blast it with a hairdryer, and then we're going to top coat, and then I'll be using the red, and I'll do the same with the gold as well, which is green for gold. So what I'm going to do now is take all the colours that I've used. So I'm going to start with the red, and I'm going to put red on, and this is where you want to get nice and neat. And then we're going to put a bit of silver in. And we're going to put a bit of black in. And then put a bit of gold. And I'm just going to do some little strokes with the brush. This can be really messy. That's what you want it to look like. A little bit like, not quite marbled, if that makes sense. What you can also do is, this is a good idea, I'll show you. Put a little bit of each colour on to some backing paper of a sculpting form. So if you think, oh, I want to add a little bit more red there, you can add that in, and you can add like a little bit of black. So you can really control it a little bit more than you can with just the brush from the bottle. You can really kind of merge those colours. So now I'm going to top coat, and I bet you're like, well, why did she put all those colours on, Pammy? You will soon see. Now, make sure you get nice and close to the cuticle with your top coat. So you seal all of that design. Now I'm going to take my e-file. I've got a round, what I call disco ball bit. And we are going to use a few different bits to get different effects. So, you see what happens as we go over with the e-file. We actually penetrate through the colours. Don't dig too deep, you've got to go careful with it. I'm going to use a bigger bit now and see what kind of effects we can get with that as well. Right, so do not wipe over with acetone. It will get rid of your colour. You want to quickly wipe with gel residue wipe off solution. You can just get rid of the dust with a brush, but I want to be super certain that there is nothing on there. Now we're going to top coat. You want the top coat to kind of fall into those slightly dipped areas.
I mean, considering how many top coats this has had, they don't look bulky, do they?
No, not at all. And it's because the metallic's so fine.
I mean, it's had, what, 5 layers of top coat?
Yeah. You pop me that in the lamp. If you have any metallic on the skin, take some acetone on a lint-free wipe, and the acetone will ease that off the skin. Because I've put a lot of layers of metallics. Because I'm going to put some crystals on, I'm going to lightly buff them because we will put top coat over the top of the acrygel. So I'm just going to lightly buff them. Make sure you don't buff through to the metallics as you'll start to remove the colour. Which is not what we want to do now. Yes, we wanted to do it before, but we don't want to do it now. Now we're going to use some acrygel to put our stones on with. I think I'm actually just going to put it on this finger and the thumb. I'm going to finish with a little bit of cuticle oil. Now we've got those little gems on. I've put a few spikes on. I kind of think this one looks like devil's horns. They look so cool.
I feel like they're the rocks you'd pass as you enter hell.
They definitely are. I love them. I like kind of, every time I look at them, I see something else. Mm. You know, like with all the layers. And I just absolutely love them. They're so different. Love it. Love it. There you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. If you recreate these nails, do hashtag Naio Nails, Kirsty Meekin, whatever you want to hashtag. Just make sure we see them because we want to have a look at them, don't we?
We do.
And make sure you hashtag. I keep going to call you goth girl. She's not.
My beautiful nightmare.
My beautiful nightmare. That's it. God. Need to remember it. Brain like a sieve. Yes, hashtag her because she wants to see them too, don't you, Abby?
I do. Yes. I want to see them.
Right, and see you later. Bye bye!
Oh, wow.
What happened there?
I stabbed myself with the
what?
Nail.
Ah.
They're pretty sharp then.
They are a bit.